You usually have some design freedom when working with filters. As we've seen in the last video, with RC filters, it's the RC time constant that ultimately determines the corner frequency. Only the product matters. It doesn't matter what R and C are individually. Only R times C makes a difference here. So should you choose a small resistor and a large capacitor, or should you choose a small capacitor and a large resistor? That's what we're going to talk about in this video. How do you get around this design freedom? My recommendation for RC filters is to choose the capacitor first. By the way, with the LR filters, it's only the quotient, the inductance divided by the resistance, that makes a difference. So we have the same question. Should you choose the resistance first and then calculate L? Or should you choose the inductor first and calculate R? I have the same recommendation. You should choose the inductor first. To see why, let's take a look at the typical range of values of inductors that we would have in a lab. For example, here in our electronics lab, we have a range of different inductor values available. The smallest inductor we have here in our rack is 150 nanohenries. Let's see what the largest inductor typically available in an electronics lab would be. It's only a millihenry. Now I hope you can see why I recommend choosing the inductor first. If you were to choose the resistor first and then calculate the inductor needed to make a filter, you'd probably find that the inductor calculated is not within the range of inductors available. We have a much larger range of resistors available. So choose the inductor first and then calculate the resistor afterwards. Now let's move on to the RC filters and we'll take a look at the capacitors available here on our rack. The largest capacitor we have available here in our lab is a 470 microfarad capacitor. It's an electrolytic capacitor and it comes in one of these cylindrical cases. You never want to use electrolytic capacitors to design filters when the corner frequency is important. That's because the capacitor value printed on the side of the case here is usually not very accurate. You only want to use electrolytic capacitors if you want to block DC but allow AC signals to pass right through the capacitor. The largest non-electrolytic capacitor we have here in the rack is a 680 nanofarad capacitor. It's not an electrolytic capacitor, so you're free to use these to design filters. But what sorts of frequencies would you target if you were going to use this kind of capacitor? I recommend that if you want to filter low frequencies, low audio frequencies, say 100 hertz, 200 hertz, up to 400 hertz or so, then this would be a good choice. If you intend to design a filter that works at high audio frequencies, like several kilohertz, then I recommend choosing a capacitor in the tens of nanofarad range. All the resistors smaller than that should be used in filters that are meant for radio frequencies, that is, several hundred kilohertz or over 1 megahertz. The smallest capacitor we have here in the rack is only 1 picofarad. I generally would not recommend using capacitors this small for your filter design unless absolutely necessary. The reason for that is capacitances this small look a lot like parasitic capacitance that are present in every breadboard between the parallel plates that run in the breadboard. If at all possible, I wouldn't choose any capacitor smaller than about 100 picofarads or 200 picofarads if you intend to build that circuit on a breadboard. So, to summarize, if you want to operate on or filter radio frequencies, choose a small capacitor 1 nanofarad or smaller, for example. If you intend to filter audio frequencies in the high audio range, choose a capacitor in the tens of nanofarad range. If you intend to filter audio frequencies that are a bit lower, like hundreds of hertz, choose a capacitor that's in the hundreds of nanofarad range. If you want to just block DC, then pick an electrolytic capacitor in the microfarad range. Generally, I recommend choosing RC filters over filters with inductors. And the reason for that is because we have a larger range of capacitor values available than we do inductor values.